Is Nano a ghost? Who is Nano? Why she's not dying? Is it a horror series? First season versus the second season? The main lesson is, so if you're gonna ask me if it is worth the watch and if I will recommend it, it's Kat and welcome back to my YouTube channel. So today is May 8, it is a Saturday. For today's video, it is another episode of Katflix. For those of you who do not know, Katflix is a series here on my channel wherein I review movies and series. Without further ado, let's go. Is Nano a ghost? Who is Nano? Why she's not dying? Those were just some of the questions that I usually see whenever I write the title of this series. So the series we're gonna review today is Girl From Nowhere. Is it a horror series? What's the difference of the second season to the first season? This series is not a typical series that you can find on Netflix. It has different theme and different plot. But if you're doubting that you are scared to watch this series, well, it's not that scary because it is not a horror series, but you will be scared on how Nano reveals the truth. So what is this series all about? Girl From Nowhere is all about a new girl in school named Nano. But who is Nano? Nano is not a ghost, but she is a daughter of Satan. That is why she is immortal. She has no emotions, she can't feel pain, and she can die multiple times. She's actually compared to the snake in the Adam and Eve. It really wasn't clear on the first season what she was doing, but on the second season, she made it clear what work she has, what job she has in this world. The ironic thing about Nano's character is that she is a demon, but she is portraying on how to be a good person. For those of you who are saying that Nano is bad, I don't think so, because Nano never actually punished anyone. She just encouraged people to do what they want without even thinking about the consequences of what they did. So for short, Nano is karma and Nano also is our conscience. So the plot is actually about Nano transferring from school to school without even getting noticed. In a way that she has the same identity, she has the same name, but nobody knows her. She actually reveals the true colors of the schools and the people. The advantage of watching this series is that kahit hindi mo siya tuloy-tuloy na panoorin, because the story is different from every episode. So let's now differentiate the first season versus the second season without spoiling anyone. So no spoilers alert. So on the first season, it has 13 episodes, while on the second season, it has 8 episodes only. The first season has the same plot all over again, but on the second season, it seems like they are building up a new story about Nano. Well, the first season is much more understandable than the second season because the second season is more complicated than the first one. You'll have more and more questions each episode, and compared to the first season, it has a darker theme. It has more violence, and I think it should have more trigger warnings. On the first season, no one actually ever said sorry to Nano. But on the second season, at least 2 people actually said sorry to her. On the first season, the 13 episodes were based on the 13 incidents where schoolgirls were victimized. While on the second season, it is a combination of the comics and the true life events that happened. On the first season, we all saw Nano's soft side to TK. But on the second season, we all saw Nano's soft side to mothers. There are actually a lot of topics tackled on this series. Mostly, it is about the social issues that we are having right now. First is the truth. The truth will always come out. Sometimes you're just sorry because you don't want to feel bad for yourself and not for the person you hurt. Not everything you see is true. If you did something wrong, don't deny it. Own up what you did, insecurity and hate. Insecurities can actually kill you. You should be contented on what you have. You should be contented on what God gave you. You shouldn't lose your dignity just to reach the top of the social status. You can't get anything good on hating someone. Beauty is in the eyes of the beholder. We are all equal. Bullying. Don't make their words put you in a box. Do not ever gossip because you'll never know how it can ruin someone. You shouldn't tell everyone about the false accusations that you have with that person. Weak can turn out to be evil. You shouldn't make other people the center of your world. You should focus on yourself, on how to become a better person. Regrets. Regrets are too late. Be careful on what you wish for. You must think of the consequences before doing something. Sometimes it's too late to realize the mistake that you did, and it is impossible for you to take it back. Even demons have hearts too. Yung ibang tao pa kaya. Old is good but must be improved. Hold your temper. Money is the root of evil. Love can make the people do crazy things. Never ever use your friends. You're a user, not a friend. With great power comes with great responsibility. Only the rich have justice. Rulemakers bend the rules for themselves. High school is all about on how famous you are and on what social status you have. But in real life and in real world, it don't matter. So the main lesson is, be careful on what you do because there is a thing called karma. Karma can come twice, thrice, or even multiple times. You should do good. You should be good to others. Whatever you do comes back to you. What goes around comes around. I think the thing about Nana is that whenever she visits a school, then she left, the memory that people have about her vanishes. Yung hindi na nila naaalala si Nano, it just automatically disappears and just learn their lessons in life. So if you're gonna ask me if it is worth the watch and if I will recommend it, my answer is definitely yes. For a horror and series lover like me, actually it is not really a horror just like what I've said, but the theme is dark and it is a suspense, it is thriller. I think even if you're not a horror lover, you'll appreciate it. You just need to have that lakas ng loob para panoorin yung every episode, because every episode talaga nandun yung thrill and yung feeling na parang hindi ka makakaya every episode kasi nandun yung thriller effect niya. But I will super recommend this series because it opens up our eyes to see the current situation, to see the current social problems that we have right now, but we are even ignoring it. We know that it is happening, but we're not doing something about it. And here is Nano giving us some lessons about it. Not the exact solution, but it is really an eye-opener. What is the season 2 all about? Nakakalito yung season 2. Daming pasabog. Who is this new girl? Why is Nano different? I need an explanation. Watch out for the part 2 of this vlog to unlock the mysteries and the unanswered questions on the season 2 of Girl From Nowhere. So that's it guys. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to like, share, comment, subscribe, and click the notification bell button for you to get notified whenever I post another video. See you on my next one. Don't forget to watch the part 2. Ciao!